So once you breathe, you can wake up in the morning and say whatever you want to say. Hope you understand. But once the air is taken from you, you are nobody. Your car, your house, your whatever, your people, it ends there. And in Ghana, nobody knows about you. That is why you have to respect anybody so your legacy can stay strong. So people can talk about your legacy.
I mean, following his
So for me, yeah. It's not about what he says about me. I pity what he says about himself or how people will see him when he talks about me. I have sung close to a decade. Maybe he has just come for 4 years and he thinks he's the ultimate. That's fine. You see? So there is no comparison. So I don't try to compare myself. So I respect his hustle and I was expecting him to respect my hustle. Even my hustle is bigger than his hustle. But I don't disrespect his hustle.
How did we get here, really?
Because you asked that question.
I mean, you and Shatta, the back and forth.
One day, I woke up in the morning, and everybody was calling my phone. And I was wondering what the situation was. And then I could remember a friend of mine rang me and said, have you seen TV, radio, whatever that's going on? I said, what? He said, oh, you know, I will show you something to you. Because I'm talking about him.
Well, just no.
No, but because I have new videos that we should be showing. So
we're showing your videos.
We can't be showing Shatta's video while I'm here talking about him.
Listen,
I didn't come here to propose Shatta Wale.
Okay, well, listen, I apologize greatly for this. We're going to return with more. You're still watching.